Hello, everyone. Hello. Welcome. Welcome to our last YouTube live for the day. I am so happy to be here, and I have another special guest here on the Team Racing YouTube channel. And I'll ask him to introduce himself and give me a little bit of his background.
What's going on, guys? My name is Tyler Benson. I'm a photographer based out of the DMV area. I currently live in Northern Virginia. I go to George Mason University, where I study cybersecurity engineering. And I'm actually on the track team there as well.
Awesome. nice having you here, Tyler. It's such a pleasure talking. Yeah.
Thank you so much for having me.
Of course. It's our pleasure. Now, you know, we are going through a very pivotal moment right now in this country. Yeah. From the pandemic to the protests to everything, and you've been a part of these protests. Yes. Tell me what that has been like for you. How many have you been to, and what's been the energy at these protests?
Yeah, so I've been to two so far. The first one I went to was in DC, and it was about 2 weeks ago, I do believe. Honestly, it was the most incredible thing I've done. I went with my friend Ian. Mm-hmm. And so we had started going down, I think it was Constitution Avenue where we were, where we parked, and we started walking down, and everybody we passed, right, there's people handing out water on the side of the road, making sure everybody's hydrated because it's a hot day. And then we came up to this one station where we could make signs. So me and him both made signs, and then we turned around and we saw this massive, like, I've never seen that many people in my life marching down the street.
Wow.
I shared a picture with you of that, but It was the most surreal feeling in the world. There had to have been probably close to 10,000 people marching straight towards us. And I was like, man, I mean, this is incredible. And I think the most incredible piece of that to me, like, it literally gave me chills, was just seeing the amount of support and the amount of people, like, really behind this movement.
Wow.
When I saw that, it was incredible. And then, so we ended up marching with them for, I think it was like 5 miles. We marched all the way around DC, went all the way to Lincoln Memorial, went up to the new Black Lives Matter Plaza. Mm-hmm. And then when we got there, we were met with probably about the double the amount of people that we had. So the whole thing, it was incredible to see the amount of people we had and the amount of just how loud our voices could possibly be. And then to know that that's really going on around the entire country, the world right now, it's such a powerful thing, and I'm glad to have been a part of it. And I will continue to go to some more. But it's just, I mean, it was incredible.
Sounds like a really, really incredible experience, really, really incredible experience. And I think one of the great things about what you've been doing is that you've been documenting and capturing these images. And I'll share a few of them with our viewers, and you can just give me some insight on them. So this one here says, hands up, don't shoot. First of all, tell me about your process and why you chose to photograph you know, what's going on, and then we can talk about each picture individually.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, so my thought process, so I've been doing photography for about 3 years, freelance work, a little bit longer than that, not freelance, but about 3 years freelance. And I just knew immediately, like, this is something that I need to be out there, I need to be documenting. I think it's important that we really get an unbiased, obviously I will be biased, however, but I want to be as clear, I want everybody to realize a lot of the media and everything like that, the mainstream media, they're going to show the rioting, the looting, the bad stuff, because that's what they want you to see. Mm-hmm. It's not all like that. Both the protests that I went to, massive amount of people, completely peaceful. And I don't think that's really gone. I don't think that mainstream media has really captured that. And then once it becomes peaceful, I tweeted this, but like, once the protests turned peaceful, they stopped covering it. And then now it looks like we don't have a voice anymore. Mm-hmm. So that's my job. That's why I do what I do. And that's why I'm going to continue to posting pictures, going and just being an advocate of being a voice on Twitter. So this picture right here, I took it at George Mason. So that's where the other protests I went to. We had a protest put together at Mason. So this is one of the ones. And what I like to take pictures of in these protests is obviously the signs, right? The signs. And you just see so many incredible things, so many incredible signs, so many incredible people and their voices. I try to keep faces out of it, which is why you'll see the backs of a lot of people's heads, but focus on the signs, because there unfortunately have been people who have been singled out because they're at the protest and not good things have happened to them. So that's what I've got. This picture right here is probably
phenomenal. It really captures the breadth off the crowd.
This is that moment. This is that moment I was talking about.
Yeah.
Seeing the amount of people, like it gives me chills at this moment. Like seeing the amount of people coming over that hill and just did nonstop. Like they just kept coming and coming. Literally no end to it.
And right here at the front, you can see, I'm not sure which type of special forces that is, which type of security that is. Yeah, but, and you can see that. Tell me about that. Where, while you were there, what was it like with, you know, the police or whomever around federal? What was that like?
Yes. So as you can see, that march was going straight towards us. Mm-hmm. And so we were at the very front of it. And obviously we had the escort going through, but what struck us when we were even walking to that protest, the amount of military vehicles that we saw, Humvees with literal like guns on the top of them. We saw full blown National Guard. We saw, I guess there must have been military police. We saw a ton of DEA. And honestly, we were kind of especially when we saw the DEA, we're like, what does the DEA do? Why would they be here? But I mean, I'm not going to lie to you. I mean, it was a little bit, at points it was a little bit nerve wracking because you're walking past, especially where we ended up parking, it was pretty much all like police and military. So it was a little bit nerve wracking going. And so we were up at the very front with the freedom fighters who were leading the march that we were at. And literally we just walked past tons and tons of cops, literally lining the roads, blocking off each of the exits, entrances. And I mean, we had come prepared with baking soda and stuff like that. Cause I mean, we don't know. You've seen so many of these peaceful protests.
Yes.
That have gotten aggravated and agitated by the police. Like the police will come and they'll be. So we were, I mean, luckily for the one that we went to, it wasn't too bad. There wasn't too many, we didn't even see any like anti-protests with people against us.
Oh, wow. Okay.
But we were lucky in that regard. But I do plan on going down to Richmond pretty soon. And I know that's going to be a whole different.
This is what I was just about to ask. I like the fact that you're going to different protests, you know, in different places. Tell me, how different was the one in D.C. from the one at George Mason? And tell me about that George Mason experience.
Yeah. So the one at D.C., like I said, a huge, massive, massive amount of people. The one at Mason, a lot more localized, but a lot more personal. So we would stop every 5 minutes or so at different locations on campus. And somebody would speak, go up and speak, talk to everybody. And those speeches with such a small crowd, there's probably about 200 people, I'd say. But with such a small crowd, like those speeches really resonated with a lot of the people there. So while you had the big, massive protests in DC, that really powerful, you hear a lot of people, a lot of voices, a lot of chanting, everybody's moving in the same direction, everything like that. So that's powerful in itself. But then when you have the very personal stories, a lot of the stories that they were talking about at the Mason one were things happening on our campus with our own student board and things like that. So that had a whole new meaning, a more personal, more effective of my specific life. So it felt a little bit more personal, not more meaningful, but it definitely had a different type of meaning.
Yes. Yeah.
And that's why I want to go down to Richmond. I have some friends that I'm going to stay with when I go down there, but that's a whole nother ball game down there.
That's what I was just going to ask. I was going to say, you know, going to Richmond, that's another experience that you know, you'll get. And do you see yourself going, you know, to other places?
No, absolutely.
Yeah,
absolutely. I actually had a friend. I wasn't able to make it to some of them. I've been doing some training and stuff like that. So I haven't been able to make it to some of them. But one of my friends, another photographer, his name's Brandon. And he actually went to, I don't remember how, probably 10 or something like that. And small ones though, like Centerville. He did one, I think, in Fairfax, things in that, and then photographed them. And that's kind of what inspired me to do it as well. And I do want to continue to go, and especially now when it's not hype, and to try and get that voice going back again, because
definitely.
And that's one of the things that I said on social media as well. At a lot of these protests, a lot of people are saying, look, social media it's not good to just do social media. And while I agree with that, I mean, 1,000,000%, you've got to be signing petitions, you've got to be donating, you've got to be using your voice, having those difficult conversations, et cetera. However, I feel like this would not be as powerful without social media.
Oh, 100%, I mean, because that's the way how we get to see what's going on, and we get to hear the personal voices of the people.
Exactly. And the mainstream media will not do that. And that is why I'm doing what I'm doing. And that's why I'm going to continue, like I said. And like I said, especially now, now's the time to be going out and really, really being loud on social media in person with everybody you know. Because the mainstream media is not going to cover it unless it gets violent again. And
definitely. Yeah. So before I let you go, you're speaking about social media, and I would love for you to put your social media out there so people can follow you. They can see the photos that you take. They can come on this journey with you and be able to see this, the history that you're capturing all across this country.
Yeah, cool. So on Instagram, which is my main photography account, is t.bensonphotos. And this is my logo. And then on Twitter, it's at Broncos Tyler. So yeah, go ahead and follow me. Like I said, I'll be keeping everybody updated. I try to be as loud as possible on social media. Anything I see, I retweet. I want to continue to have the presence. I may be small, but any voices are helping at this point, you know what I'm saying? So
of course. And thank you so much, Tyler. It's been such a pleasure talking with you today.
No,
it's been such a pleasure to see your photos and just to see what you're capturing for all of us here. And trust me, these photos will go down in history. Years from now, we'll be able to look back on them and see something, you know, from the ground.
Exactly.
From the ground, what was happening.
Absolutely. So, yeah. No, thank you so much for having me. It's been awesome. Keep doing what you guys are doing, because again, you're really helping everybody else give a voice. So thank you so much. Yeah,
thank you so much. All right, Tyler, you have a good one now. And for viewers, thank you for watching. Bye
guys.